Hi everyone, I'm Benjamin Blau, and I don't know about you, but I can't wait for SAP Tech at 2022. You should definitely check out the sessions on SAP's applications and business processes. Want to get an exclusive glimpse into the future of CRM? Then watch out for the CX Subtrack to get first-hand insights into the SAP Customer Experience portfolio and what it can do for your business. Explore the new Intelligent Sales and Service Cloud. Learn how to connect your ecosystem to the customer data platform. And see for yourself how SAP CX is embarking on its journey to the metaverse. Also, don't miss out on customers showcasing their use of the entire CX suite.
Learn how SAP's S/4HANA solution, the SAP B2B platform with its vibrant ecosystem, and the SAP Business Network create a unique and extensible platform for you to tackle your supply chain challenges.
Then check out the HXN Subtrack to learn more about next generation cloud delivery, architecture transformation, application modernization, critical suite quality for delivering the intelligence enterprise strategy, such as identity management, and explore the capabilities of SAP Worksong. Join us at TechCat to learn how SAP's HXN solutions will help your organization to prepare for the needs of future workforce and how we are innovating with SAP Business Technology Platform.
So next week at TechEd, you're going to hear lots of SAP Cloud Application Programming Model news and have opportunities to learn all kinds of things about it. But actually, before we all jump into TechEd mode, we've got some hot news on the October 2022 release of SAP Cloud Application Programming Model. There are several key new features in this release. We see new localization support available in extensions, a new SAP Fiori analytics list page in the sample application, the S-Lite sample. So if you've wanted to learn more about analytics list pages, definitely check out that sample. We see the ability to reuse annotations by attaching them to an aspect in the CDS language section. In Node.js, we've got the additional consumption of dead letter queue when it comes to eventing, simplified usage of correlated subqueries, and some SAP-specific EDMX annotations now respected in the service consumption model as well. On the Java side, there's also important changes that you should check out, including significant performance optimizations in the Java runtime, and that H2 2.0 is now the default database when you are doing early testing before you're ready to deploy your application. We also see support for download repositories with authentication when you need to connect and consume third-party and other types of libraries in the Java runtime. And finally, create CDS QL statements from the result object is now possible in the Java runtime as well. So as always, check out all the change log in the CAPIRE documentation for full details. And I hope everybody's planning to tune in next week for the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model lecture and hands-on sessions where you'll learn even more about great new things coming to the CAP programming model in the near future.
There's a new tool to help with your end-to-end testing. If you test with OPA 5 or VDI 5, you can now use the recently released UI 5 Journey Recorder. This is a Chrome extension that allows you to record your user movements throughout a UI 5 website and provides you with OPA 5 or VDI 5 test journeys. It's simple to use. Just attach to your website, point, click, type whatever you need, and get your generated code. The UI 5 Journey Recorder is a simple tool to add to help with testing and is linked in the description below. Happy coding!
Next week, November 15th and 16th, is SAP TechEd, long-awaited technical event of the year. Now, the developer advocates are going to be bringing you lots of content live from SAP TechEd in Las Vegas. First of all, we're going to have special episodes of the developer news that you'll find right here on our SAP Developers YouTube channel on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday evening. We'll release special episodes that recap some of the major announcements and news from SAP TechEd. You'll also find the developer advocates performing demos in the opening keynote on day one. We'll have the developer download session at the end of day one. And There, we're going to show lots of additional tech demos that support some of the announcements and things you're going to hear about at TechEd, as well as recap some of the great things that happened on day one. And if you are there with us in person in Las Vegas, then be sure to stick around after the developer download and join us for the evening reception, where we'll also be adding in a hacker night. It's a great opportunity to network with other developers and exchange ideas, maybe engage in a little coding, play some video games. We're going to have lots of fun activities, and we look forward to seeing you. So whether you're joining us for the online event or joining us in person in Las Vegas, we can't wait to interact with you at TechEd this year.